Hey guys, it's Calvin and welcome back to Resident Evil 7. We are now on the tanker, or the tanker, is that what you call it? Like a boat? It's locked from the other side. And we're actually uncovering the mystery of what Mia had to do with this whole entire thing. Ethan knows that she had something to do with it, it's just up to us to actually like kind of wean it out, I guess. Like we're on the third floor here. Should be a lot of fun. Look at this bitch. Look at this bitch sitting in a swivel chair. Hey! Oh my god.
What? Why?
You need to remember, so we can be a family.
I said in the last one that this is my favorite environment in the entire game, and it's probably one of my top 5 favorite environments in Resident Evil, period. And it's rooms like that, just with her sitting there. What does it say? Mia Winters. So this is her, Mia Winters. Test subject E001. So guys, this is something I didn't pick up on at first. But on the picture, I'm not gonna spoil it for anyone who doesn't know actually. But it will show up later. And I'll show it to you guys, like, you know, we're gonna see it a bit later on as well. No point in like hiding it. Apparently the loading screens on PC are like non-existent.
She must have infected me during the attack. And I'm too far gone anyway. But it serves me right. It's my fault she got out.
Yeah, it is your fault. But that doesn't mean I'm gonna let you die.
She didn't attack you?
It's part of her imprinting protocol. I can't believe this is happening.
Here. Take it. It has her tissue samples. You find her. You fix this.
Okay, Evie. Where are you?
Okay, Evie, where are you? Special Operations Division Director Alan Droney and caretaker Mia Winters. Recent reports suggest that if Evelyn remains at her current location, she is at high risk of being stolen by the opposing organizations.
Could we be talking about Umbrella?
She is at high risk of being stolen by opposing operations. Your orders, therefore, are to transfer Evelyn. I keep saying Evelyn because, like, that's like that you can say it like that as well, I guess, but it's Evelyn, you know, even in Ireland it's Evelyn, to our Central American branch for safekeeping until further notice. During transfer, be sure to adhere to the following protocols. Act as a parental guardian for Evelyn at all times. Manage Evelyn's vitals via genome codex provided. If the mission is compromised beyond reconciliation, dispose of Evelyn. Machine gun Eddie. So there you go. It has been compromised, there's no doubt about that. We could use the Albert right now, but that is so cheap. That is so cheap to use the Albert right now. I mean, so guys, I just censored myself again there because of a spoiler, and I hope you understand why.
She's close.
Wait. Did I get my... Is there like a gun in here I can get? Oh, I already have it. I already have the machine gun. Okay. I think there's no point really censoring myself as much. I'll try not to show it as much. I'll try not to have you guys notice it as much. Because in all honesty, I don't want to ruin this game for people. I really don't. Especially if people are watching along while I'm playing. A lot of people probably seen this game already. Probably seen people finish it. I know Harshly Critical has this game finished already. Fair play to him. I finished this game once myself. Okay, let's see what we can do here, actually. Okay, so she's close by. Or at least something to do with her is close by. So the door is closed behind us, by the way, if anyone's wondering what those sounds are. It's not too serious. We don't have to worry about it. This honestly feels really good. Like, running along with a, I don't know, it just feels good. I like the idea of running along with a machine gun in my hand. Feels really good. Okay, we were just in here. Let's do this. Okay, so she's close by in here, or at least we're told she's close by in here. So there's this gook here, which is disgusting. There's some machine gun ammo, I believe. I'm not a big fan of the machine gun. In general. the shotgun's amazing. The shotgun is just an amazing gun. I like it a lot.
She's ugh. Fine. Damn, I'll have to reset.
How's it going?
She's vomiting. Far more in excess of her body mass.
Oh, great. We're gonna be seeing a lot more of her ugly friends if this keeps up. All right, we need to find her and fast. This is getting out of hand.
Agreed.
Can watches do that now? Like, is that like a thing that watches can do? Can watches legitimately call people now? That's insane. Like, a lot of people might be like, oh, well, it's not that interesting, Calvin. I think that's really interesting. That watches can, like, call people. Again, that's just me. Oh, here we go. Okay, let's save ammo. Let's do this. Let's do this typical Resident Evil style, how you would do it back in the day. Let us save ammo here. Why not? Why not save some ammo? Let's just go around. In fact, let's try and jostle this guy into a position. Oh, don't come in here, friend. Don't come in here. I like playing like this. I think it's a legitimate way to play this as well, you know? Just conserve your ammo. I want to check what this does, if this door will open. No, it won't. Okay, that's good. It's locked from the other side. I've never been on a boat before myself, guys. I'll tell you that right now. I've never been on a boat. I've never been on a plane either. How can I make this thing work? Like this, I guess. Okay, here we go. Oh god. We're playing Resident Evil style, man. Okay. No! No, 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 no! Okay, okay, where are we going? Stay back, please. I wanted to, like, just not kill him. Like, do a pacifist run of Resident Evil 7. Is it possible? It's very possible. No, it's not possible, actually, sorry. It's not even nearly possible. So right now we're on the look for Evelyn. Evelyn is being, oh god, sorry. Evelyn's being a little bit of a hard case. She's not being very helpful with any of us. We're all just trying to help her. Oh, here's one of the tougher ones, actually. Can they break through doors? I think they can probably break through wooden doors if they tried. You know what I mean? I don't think they can break through, metal doors. I think that's, like, one of the reason, like, it's kind of like, in the original Resident Evil, like, once you got past the door, you were pretty much safe. Remote bomb is really, really important in this area. Like, unbelievably important. Invaluable. When fighting some of these creatures. Hello? Oh, sorry, sir. I didn't mean to, offend. See you later. I'm gonna go this way. This is probably gonna bite me in the ass later on. But I don't care. And that closed behind me, which is good. There's some dead bodies around here as well. You know, I like games that remind me of the original Resident Evil. If you're reminding me of the original Resident Evil, I think you've done a good job already. I think any game does a good job if they remind me of the original Resident Evil.
I think she's on the other side of this door. But I don't have a key.
Try to melt down the lock. You're on the bottom level, right? Check our luggage.
So we read that earlier about a couple. That they are definitely pretending to be a part of, at least. Oh, we got the good, really good knife. Oh, I love this knife. It's so good. So, such a good knife. I thought that was the monster sound. For people that probably think that this is, that these two guys are intimate together, I am gonna go against it and say they are not. You can tell me if you think they became intimate or something like that, but honestly, I think they're just pretending, like it says in the memo. Pretending to be a couple.
Are you mad at me, Mommy?
No.
Yes.
No. I'm not mad. Wait. What did you call me?
I don't want to live at the lab anymore. I want a house. And I want you to be my mommy.
Okay, Evie. I'll be your mommy. Just come back with
me. Evie, wait!
Did you find her?
Yes, but she ran off. She's making more friends, Alan. Those things are everywhere.
I told you so.
Are you okay?
You just worry about getting Evelyn back.
Alan just coughing up a goddamn lung and back there. I feel for him. I feel for him a lot. This is very Resident Evil 2, I think, the siren. I hate comparing other games to other games, but I just feel like it's like this whole game is a really nice homage to the original Resident Evil. I feel like that's what they were going for, right? Talk to you later, I'm gonna go this way. Oh shit, better hit you here. Double tap X, by the way. If anyone's wondering. Oh, I love that. There we go. We're doing good. We got some more acid as well and some remote bombs. It was 110% worth it to come in here. That's what I would say. If people are playing this game on their second playthrough or on their first playthrough or whatever, I'd say don't be afraid to just use these all the time. Wait, did we go the right way? Wait, what? Did I go the right... here? Oh yeah, this is definitely the right way. Here's another herb. We're not gonna be able to use these, I don't think, in our... Oh, let's just use a remote bomb. Let's just use it here. How do you attach it to someone? You can attach it to someone, I know that. I know you can attach it to someone's back, and I really want to do it, like, right now. Oh, fuck. Oh, God. Was that fun for you guys? It was fun for me. It was incredibly fun for me. Jesus Christ, Evie. Evelyn! Evelyn! Oh. Oh God, let me in. Whew, I think we're doing good. We're going to the third floor. This just looming overhead as well.
Emergency safety lockdown system has been engaged.
You can engage it all you want, we're doing fine here. Okay. So yeah, like, look at this. Look, how can you not be, like, absolutely in love with the environment of this game? There's just something so good about it. Okay, we're back. Are we back in this area that we were before? I think we are, so now we can go and get some of the stuff that we can get here. Let's start with this, I guess. And I think it's some remote bombs. Exactly, so useful. I love it. It's not me being sarcastic as well. It's actually pretty useful to use these remote bombs. Let's not do that again to me. Ooh, okay, so we can use it here. Or we can... No, we're gonna use it here. Because they put enough corrosive acid to get every single thing in this game, I think. And these are so useful now. We might as well use these. I don't think we're gonna be able to use them if we go back, so... We might as well. See you later. Wait, we're supposed to go here. She wants us to go here. Can we throw these? No? Okay, let's just use these on the way up. I think we have to go up, right? Oh man, this whole game is so good. And like, the sad thing is, it's like, it's not gonna get like the massive amount of credit it deserves for being such a fantastic game. It never will, because in no game past the 90s it will ever be called someone's favorite game of all time. Maybe by some. Persona 4 is one of my favorite anyway. Hey man, look at this. What do you think of that? Wasn't that cool?
How did you
okay?
get here?
Where's Evie?
She's out of control. Without the treatments, she's deteriorating.
Well, it's a good thing we're already dying.
Don't say that.
She trusts you. That little bitch, she never trusts. Okay, wait. Evie!
Alan, listen!
I didn't mean to call you that!
She's
Evie,
trying to take control! You have to fight her! Evelyn, stop! Stop right now!
Don't touch me, don't!
This to me is one of the more sad things in the game, you know? You get to see exactly what happened to Mia. Why she is the way she is. And how she was literally just trying to help this little bitch of a girl. E-001. And now we get to reveal a bit more as well.
Yes, Evelyn. I remember.
Can we be a family like before?
No, Evie. We can't be a family. We were never a family. We will never be a family.
Then I don't need you anymore.
All right, Evie, you fucking bitch. Let's do this. She doesn't need me anymore. I don't need her anymore. Okay, we can save here. It's pretty good though. I like it a lot. I like it a lot. I don't know. This game is fantastic. It always has been. For the past week that people have been playing it, I'm so glad that people appreciate it a lot. Because it deserves that. It really does. And it's not even a thing of like, it doesn't deserve that appreciation, Calvin. It really does. It deserves it so much. Like, it's not that good. It's really good. It's really good. Okay, so over here, we have a corrosive door that we can use some corrosives on it. We have the laptop that we use our shit on. We have this. We don't have a lockpick. We have some machine gun ammo, which we don't have a machine gun. We're back to regular old bullets. We have some gunpowder. Can we make one of these? Can we make one of these? No, we cannot. Okay. We're doing pretty good. I think we're doing pretty good for ourselves. So now that we have the elevator open, we can actually go over here and probably get some ammo as well, actually. Or something out of this, at least. Chem fluid, which means you can make bullets. Which is what we need more than anything right now. Health is great. Like, having some health is fantastic, but having ammunition is probably even more important. At least in this situation. Now, I really love the direction this game took as well, because it's, you know, for me, for a while there, when before the game came out, I was like, how are they going to sustain this much? You know, how are they going to make this much, you know, how are they going to put this much into a video game? How are they going to, you know, how are they going to, like, get an 8-hour game out of this? How are they going to get a 6-hour game out of this? And it just turns out that They can get a 6-hour game out of this pretty easily, and not only that, but they also added this in, which makes the game even larger. Okay. Let's check around for some ammunition first. Got a remote bomb. It's always good. This is just a regular handgun, it's not like our old handgun, so don't be expecting any miracles from me. More gunpowder. Toilet paper. Toilet paper. If anyone gets that reference, please tell me.
Maybe it still works.
Okay, change camera. We're looking for our boyfriend or husband. There he is.
Ethan. I hope I make it in time. Okay, bottom level. Hallucinations. Where is she?
If I can be like 100% honest with you guys, I always try to be, but to me, I don't find little girl ghosts scary. I know that I probably should. Let's see what we can do down here. Actually, we should probably find the map first of all. Yeah, we should find the map. That place is blocked off anyway. We can't go there. Okay, let's open this up first. This is where we were before. I don't know what it is like. It's not that scary to me. I'm sure if I saw it in real life, I'd be terrified, but right now, in this particular moment in time, it does not terrify me at all. Ship map, which is something we need. Lug wrench is something we need even more. We need the key to this. Yeah. We're doing fine. Okay, I think we're done here. Yep, I think we're done here. But now since we have the lug wrench, we can actually use this here. Man, I'm playing The Witcher 3 right now. I'm trying to complete Blood and Wine for a second time. And like, holy crap, like the fall damage in that game is just insane. Like, you might as well give up on playing the game if you're planning on doing any jumping. My favorite thing about that game is, like, when you're jumping and... What's just below me? Oh, God. Oh, okay, we're fine. So we need a wire and a fuse. Get back here. I love that he realizes he can't get me and he's like, oh, shit. Stop being unfair. The survival knife. Okay, so where we gotta go here? There's not many doors we can look into here. Actually, there is quite a few. We need corrosives for this door. Huh. I think this is our... Right, shot to the head. Okay, some of those were not shots to the head. We gotta remember that in future. 16 years since the nightmare of Raccoon City. The survivors are still suffering. Mm-hmm. You never really think about that, do you? Do you, though? Survive the other survivors other than... You know, I don't have the wristband. Oh, yeah, she doesn't have the wristband. She has to, like, rely solely on... Oh, yeah. This door is open for some reason now. Well, I guess I probably opened it myself somehow. Let's see what we can get here. I'll take this. I'll take that. And I'll take what's ever in here as well. I love this box. This is like an old box you'd find in like your grandmother's shed or something. Okay, I think we're fine. And there's that there. I'm not looking for collectibles right now. If I'm honest. Okay. Whew, calm down, Calvin. I don't need to. I don't have any remote. Oh, I do have remote bombs. Okay, that's good. That was a good shot. That was a good shot. This opens now though, right? Yeah, because I unlocked it. And also this is opened. Which means you can get some corrosive things here. This has to be level up, right? There we go. That's like a very Resident Evil puzzle, you know what I mean? That's like just extremely Resident Evil. Now that we have that though, we can actually go and get some other stuff that we probably may have missed. Or that we couldn't have gotten the first time. So let's go get that stuff right now, actually. Actually, let's head for the save room is probably the best option we can have now. Because there is a lot of doors we can open, but I think that the best option for ourselves in this situation is probably to, get back to the save room. You okay, buddy? The no-arm ones are really tough. I swear they're supposed to be tough. Okay. So I'll end the episode there, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'm sorry if there was a weird cut in between there. I don't know if it was or not. I will see you guys very soon. Bye-bye. And I should probably say, a lot of the episodes next week from Wednesday to about Friday or Saturday morning, maybe, are pre-recorded. I won't be recording them on the day. Because I have some business to attend to. I won't have internet, like, I won't have the internet for 2 days. I'm doing something really cool. Obviously, I'm not going to go too far into my own personal life, but it's not some spiritual journey, don't worry. But I won't be able to reply to comments for 2 days, but I will reply to them when I come back. So, feel free to make comments from Wednesday morning to Wednesday morning GMT to Saturday morning GMT, and I could possibly be back by then.